Hey guys, welcome to the General Banter Podcast. This is a regular broadcast going out on a Tuesday, available to everyone. Yeah?
Yep.
Not behind a Patreon paywall, you know, the way they should be. This one is the Soup Kitchen Podcast that you turn up and you get for free. Saint. Amta?
Giving it away.
I'm a full podcast Nazi now that I have a Patreon.
Are you?
I hope you fucking enjoy this absolute freebie. And if this is all you listen to, I hope you have a good life. I'm nasty today, Maureen.
I know you are. Very saucy today.
I've got a pain in my back. It's been there for about 6 weeks. Some might think of that as quite sinister, you know? But it's really affected my mood, which is a good thing to know.
Yeah,
it's something sore. It's sore. So, as usual, there's nothing to plug. We do have Patreons on the podcast. Podcasts on Patreon. Spare ones, yeah. That's how we work it now. I record this every Tuesday. And then, you know, the rest of the days I do podcasts on Patreon. And very often, you know, I get through all the good information on the Patreon ones. And by the time it gets around to a Tuesday, I'm like, I'm struggling for ideas. And that's why my guest is here today, Máirín.
Cheers. Thank
my
you.
My legal wife. So, yeah, you're here. Because to be honest, if you want to just crack on, I'll turn my mic off. You can just chat away. People want to hear from you more than they want to hear from me.
Gosh,
that's how
really?
My podcast career is going. Everyone's like, yeah. Oh, yeah, I used to listen to yours. And then 20 other NI comedians have podcasts. And now if I'm really bored, I'll listen to yours. That's what they say. And then when they hear you're coming on, they're going, oh, that's class. Would it be cool if you weren't on? People want to hear from you mainly. That's what
Colin,
they say.
You're in a very bad mood today. What's wrong?
I'm just in a bad mood. What are you in a bad mood every day?
I know.
Why do you think people listen to this? They listen because they're going, what sort of rager is he on this week?
I know.
But can't wait. He just did the SSE. He must be on top of the world. No, I ranted about a burger that they made with my fucking name on it that I didn't get. I was fucking livid. Livid. Patreon.com/GeneralBanterPodcast for more of that. There's a big giant cock over there. I just keep seeing it on the side of your face every time.
Is there like a liquid dripping from it?
I took it in one day and washed it. And it's difficult to wash a dildo.
It's too realistic now because it's like
glistening.
Actual flesh looking now. Even though it's painted and everything. But
it's hard to wash a dildo, I would say, in public.
How did you do it?
The Swiss milk.
And now, do you already know that? Because in baby massage, that's actually a term in baby massage.
Maureen took a baby massage class, and everything that the woman said, I was thinking that would feel good in your penis.
Because you're disgusting.
She's like, you get two hands, it's covered in oil, and you're kind of drawing it towards you and twisting simultaneously. That's called a Swiss milk. And I was like, put the Swiss milk myself on my old Toblerone. It's Billy Collinger. Me and Roger Federer, Swiss milk. He's not even Swiss. Where's he from? Belgian?
Somewhere else. Good for chocolate, I don't know.
Now we've went on a tange already. Where's he from? Is he Swiss?
I don't know. This is one of those facts that you're like,
Nash.
I don't really keep those facts in my brain.
Where's he from? Whitesville. Switzerland? He is Swiss.
There you go.
Well, so he's Swiss milking. And have you ever seen his arms?
No.
He's definitely been Swiss milking with one hand.
Well, he's a tennis player, Colin.
That's what he tells you.
He doesn't tell me anything.
All right. He's got one arm that looks like the arm's been in a wheelchair forever. What's that noise? Where's your phone? Put it in the bin.
There's no noise in my head.
Just put it over there anyway.
It's too close to the dildo now. I don't like it.
Say it stopped.
Right, there was no noise in my headphones.
And you're wanting to do a podcast and you don't even know the professionalisms.
You asked me to do it.
I know, but it's only to exploit you so that I get listeners.
Ugh.
Because no one listens to mine anymore. Only joking.
What are you... Your brain has gone mad today.
Roger Federer has one big arm, one wee arm. Look at that. Pow, pow.
But surely there's more power in one arm.
Yeah, he plays tennis mainly anyway. With the one arm, yeah. But he's been Swiss milking. So what were we talking about there?
Who knows? Did she have a breakdown?
Yeah, kind of a wee bit. Play intro. See what happens.
The General Banter Podcast with Colin Geddis.
Right about now, baby. I want you to get yourself and your soul together. This man will make your liver quiver. This man will make your bladder splatter. Let's all welcome the world's godfather of soul.
Colin Geddis.
It's Geddis, actually.
Geddis.
Geddis.
Geddis. Geddis. Geddis.
Fuck you. Have you seen this video? We'll start off with this. I have to play it through Twitter. So let me set the scene. It's the Holy Land. Have you seen this?
I don't think so.
It's the Holy Lands. There's a bunch of chicks making a... By the way, the Holy Lands, you're used to it because you've maybe seen it a couple of times. When you see it on video, you're like, where is this? Bosnia? Do you know what I mean? You're like, what the fuck? I don't even know where Bosnia is. Near Switzerland.
Everything's near Switzerland.
What's this?
I'm in the ghetto. Ratatata. I'm in the ghetto. Ratatata.
Do y'all know the Holiday Inn at?
First of all, she has that, like, you know, I've had 50 double fucker Red Bulls voice where it's like, you know.
Yeah.
And she's going, ratatata. I'm in the ghetto. So posh, probably. You know, she's probably like, ah, da, da, da. My daddy didn't pick me up from in the Range Rover from club. Ah, da, da, da. I mean, that's her. She's loving it. She's like, I can't wait to move in to the Hollands for, it's pronounced Hollands, for the semester and just trash the place because I've no respect for it whatsoever. Yeah,
look at me being a student, guys.
Guys, I'm a student.
Look at me slumming it.
Yeah. Guys, we'll go out and we'll go back and we'll order some food, will we? What do you fancy? Avo on toast? I can make it happen at 3 in the morning, honestly. What do you want?
What does he say?
Y'all know what a Holiday Inn is?
Do y'all know what a Holiday Inn
is? It just sounds like he goes... Remember, she's going, na 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 na, and he's like, you know what, na 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 na. He's trying to communicate with her.
I'm in the ghetto, ratatata. I'm in the ghetto, ratatata.
Do you know what, Holiday Inn?
It's funny because, yeah, you totally feel like she's like, I'm staying at my friend's house, but let's not fuck about. Tomorrow morning, I'll be getting a private chauffeur to take me back to my apartment, my student apartment, that's only 60,000 square feet up the Malone Road.
Writes in her diary, met a black man today.
Yeah. Daddy, I seen a black. I seen a black and he said, you know what happened to him?
What?
He was like grinding on some fat bitch in Thompson's who was like over from somewhere for a hen do? Hen do? Dag do? What's it called? Hen do?
Yeah.
Yeah, and they were at Benedict's or something, and they were in Thompson's, and then she's like, I send a hardy in, oh, I love black lads. And then he's just walking around the Holy Lands going, where the fuck am I, Bosnia? What had it in it? Excuse me, what had it in it? Hey ladies, what had it in it?
Just wraps everything.
What had it in it? He was considerably chirpy for that time of night. What had it in it? What other places are there? Where's the E-top? The E-top, you're definitely banging some gross bitch on a stag day, aren't you? What had it in it? Where's he? Is so lost. Like,
there is a Holiday Inn in Holy Land.
You know, he'd be like, phone his me, yo man, I'm lost. And they're like, where are you? And he goes, he'd be like, the plane ticket said Belfast, but it seems to me like I'm in fucking Romania. It's full of fucking Romanians and the houses look like Romania, you know? And for some reason, there's a Thai restaurant in the middle. And every voice I do slowly turns into Tiger King. And I'm very...
yeah, why is that?
I'm very salivy. By the way, every podcast during the lockdown is going to come right back to Tiger King and what you've learned since you've rewatched it. What a hot did it in it? What a E-tap at? What a Radisson at? What a Fitzadero... What's it called? What a Europa at?
The Europa?
Yo, man, I'm looking for the Europa. It's the bomb, literally, many times. Yo, man, I'm looking for the ropa. Ropa? I don't know what's funnier, him or her, just going, hey, la, 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 la. I don't mess with peasants. I'm in the ghetto. She's on a bike and she's like, I'm in the ghetto.
Yeah, he has a bike in Holland.
She's just been on a fucking, the guy that stole it from somewhere. But she, you know, she's been so used to being picked up in like a Rolls Royce. Or know what she's thinking? She's going, Ruthie, do you know what I'm on? A metal horse. I normally have a real horse at home. It's worth fucking 78 grand. Know what this is? A metal horse. A metal wheel horse. La 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 la. You will never get this. I'm in the ghetto. What a had it in it. Just that guy. People must be so let down when they come to Belfast. Man, we going to Belfast. We going to tear it up. And it's like 1 o'clock. Make our way at the back place. Yo, man, where's all the bitches and weed? There's no fucking, there's none.
Way home.
Get a fucking friend. Go to bed. You have to get up in the morning and go look at some fucking hedges. Get the fuck out of bed. Take out the back place. That's all that happens.
See, you could not even say any words there. And it just sounds like a da, 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 da.
Like a bouncer?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. They don't know.
You don't even have to say words.
You could be saying anything.
You could say anything.
You could walk out and be like, good, kill all the children. You know, just most racist shit. You don't need to back out, get all the Asians in the country, fuckers, eh? Get the back, please. Go ahead. Fuck all the bullshit. Just whatever the fuck. Well, in the back of all the Holocaust didn't even happen.
Just admit in your darkest secrets that no one will ever know.
Yeah. Oh, in the back, then I go home and cry, hit my life, go ahead, in the back.
I killed someone.
Well, in the back, some of us have body parts in a boot to get rid of. What a fuck, 44. Well, go ahead, take our drinks out of the back. Oh, fuck, yeah, just total creeper.
Maybe that'd be really good if you want to be a bouncer, but...
Well, lads, out the back, I have a hard drive full of cherry porn, out the back, oh, come on, the fuck...
All right, Colin, that's enough, man.
What?
That's enough.
What?
That's too much now.
It's funny, but...
That's it, too much.
What had it been on here?
Right, well, that's you saying that for the next 2 weeks.
I know. I'll be like, where's my shoes? And also, what had it been on here?
What was a song you couldn't stop singing? And you don't sing songs ever. It actually makes you cringe, and you could not stop singing it. I actually... I had to shout at you for singing it so much because I've never ever seen you do this before. Oh my God, yeah, I just remember what it is.
Do you know what the thing is? I seen this on TikTok and it's quite funny, but it's basically one line of the song and the rest of it's cack.
But you literally would wake up singing it. Just did a bad thing. I regret the thing I did. And it's so you, it's such a line for you.
Story of my life.
I think that's why you liked it. Because after everything you do, you just say this. I regret the thing I
did. If it's one rule I live by, it's act first, think later.
Well, how's that working out?
Not well. And you're wondering what it is. Tell you what I did. It's crap. There's a lot of songs like that. You know, Baker Street. Then there's a full song after it. There's a lot of songs like that. Layla. And that slows way down. There's a song. This is the same. He goes, I regret the thing I did. And then it's a full song. And you're like, I don't
want
to hear it.
You just want this. The bad thing.
This is how long this should be. I regret the thing I did. Would have had it in it. Great stuff. Great start to the podcast.
So, there you go.
So we're in the midst of coronavirus. And
we're not talking about it anymore.
It's going in a loop now. I mean, everyone has a podcast. Everyone's going to be talking about the same thing. Everyone's going to be talking about coronavirus, how they're getting through it. Everyone is a quiz master.
See, ironically, it's supposed to like sort of make people more inventive, having to be at home. But realistically, everyone's kind of just now turning into the same people.
Now, what I don't like is when people are, you know, like, I normally, you know, worked in a bank, but now that I'm off, I'm Vincent Van Gogh. I hate that. And people are like, do you know what?
Well, you hate people trying new skills.
But I hate them showcasing it. Like, man, this has been locked in my heart forever. And they're like, oh, you know, I was always shy about saying it, but I actually really like making fucking ashtrays out of Play-Doh. And then they put up like three things that look like a mashed up asshole. And they go, thanks. And then someone would be like, Tina, so many talents, hon. And she'd be like, thank you so much. I was embarrassed about posting. And you fucking should be. Everyone's like that, aren't they? Just one. I bought a coloring book.
Well, everyone wants to show you how they make their dinner now. And you're like, everyone makes dinner every day.
Yeah.
Unless it's something real interesting or someone who actually makes food. I enjoy watching them, don't get me wrong.
I get asked all the time.
But only people who can make up their own recipes, where you go, oh, what a great idea. Not just people making their dinner.
Yeah.
Hey guys, here's how I make chicken, you know, curry. And you're like, yes.
Yeah.
What?
Why? I mean, shout out to our boy Danny O'Brien down there. He's a big foodie, but then sometimes he'll just be like,
person.
Okay guys, here for breakfast I'm having yogurt with fucking oatmeal in it, or with like granola in it, and then here's how I make it. And you're like,
did you just say oatmeal?
I couldn't think of it. What was it called? Granola?
Fucking porridge.
What is oatmeal? No, I meant granola.
I know, that's why I'm laughing.
Because in my head I was going like oats and bits
and
of stuff.
And then this is when you sing your song.
I regret the thing I did.
Do you know what's funny? Because you have to sing it like a really cute little airy voice.
No, this is my life. This is my song. My song goes like this. I just did a bad thing. Right? And then I go like this. I regret the thing I did. And then it plays and then I go, only joking, I don't give a fuck. And I'll do it again several times.
I know.
I pretended that I cared. To act like an actual human, I couldn't give a fuck. I'll bin it and buy another one. Did you actually rocket snot? I'll break a pen and I'll get another one. NFG. No fucks give out.
No fucking pens left. That's all you do all day.
Hold on a second.
What?
Oh, it says 1 hour. I thought that said 1 minute left. I was about to fucking lose my mate. What a holiday, ain't it? Poor bastard. Him and his mates.
Just keep wiping my nose.
Man, we over here at the
moment. No, hurry my nose. Usually that stops your, like, your nose running all day.
Your snots.
Yeah, it's really weird.
You got the clean whistle now.
So clean. It's really clean, but
can you
it's
feel it annoying. Like, can you get a big deep breath? Because I struggle with that sometimes.
It does feel, yeah.
Some depend on my, like, body temperature or whatever. Sometimes my nose just doesn't take in air. Sometimes it feels like it's inflamed. Sometimes it's not. But I would love that big.
No, it's weird.
But then the snots are just falling out.
Not really, but you just find that your nose will just drip. And you're like, where did that? You've no, like, there's no sense. You know, usually you can feel if your nose is running.
Yeah.
Because everyone has tiny hairs in your nose. Like, yeah. You'd feel it. Whereas I'll just turn around and I can literally, and it's so gross, but like your nose will just drip up. And you're like, where did that come from? Because you can't feel it coming out of your face.
And you're also like,
so weird.
COVID-19, where'd that come from?
No, I know. That's so gross, isn't it?
Fucking,
yeah, well, I don't go anywhere.
I'm in the ghetto. La 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 la.
I just haven't left my house in weeks.
Dripping snot on peasants.
I've driven something anyway. Let's go through a lot of tissues.
I did a snot thing. I regret the snots I did.
Right, if we're talking about gross things, I can talk about you.
Oh, yeah. I've got this real cool habit of, right now, our baby boy child, Eddie, is being looked after by Maureen's sister for an hour while we do this podcast, just in the house there.
Which is hashtag still social distancing because she basically lives with us.
Yeah, she lives very close and she wasn't outside the house for about a month.
She basically works for us. So
she works for us, like, who doesn't?
She hasn't been anywhere else or worked with anyone in months.
Anyway, basically, your mum does it too, and now your sister, where they have a habit, when they come in the house, they go straight to our downstairs toilet. Like, they don't have many toilets down there.
And yeah, there's about 12 toilets in the house.
There's more toilets than there is people and rooms.
Yeah.
And hot dinners. And speaking of hot dinners, twice now, in quick succession, they've come in the house, kicked their flip-flops off, went straight to the toilet. Moments after I've just dropped an absolute heater in the toilet.
It was so bad today, I said to you, are they muck spreading outside?
What's the difference? It's only smells. That's from a different podcast. But listen, people say, open the window. You don't open the window because it blows the shit stink back into the house.
It will close the toilet seat. Isn't that a good thing to do?
It doesn't. Do they close? Is that not fixed to the back? Does that close down?
Yes.
Oh, I thought it was to stop you pissing over the back, the cistern.
Were you like trying to like peel onto the back of it so it like shoots back in like you're doing a basketball dunk?
I thought it was just like
Talking of which, basketball dunks? We've got a new basketball
I thought it was just like, and we're not done with the shits yet. But they have an issue of like coming straight in and going straight into the toilet.
Yeah.
And you're like, bro.
You couldn't have timed it any better.
You know, your mum went straight in the other day, and I wasn't even like, you know, sometimes you'd be like embarrassed about it. I was like, fucking enjoy that. I'll teach you, pee at home. And then she'll go home and be like this. I just did a bad thing. I regret the thing I did. You know what I mean? I smell a bad thing. Must be a man doing a shit.
There probably should be a toilet where it's just like you could have your own toilet somewhere.
I'd love it. I think it's called an apartment. Get me one.
Okay, yeah. That's a good idea. La 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 la. I'm
in the ghetto. That'd be me. Every house should literally have, you know.
You need an outside toilet.
I need a house outside because a dog house. More, a man cave, they call it, but
it's a dog house.
A lot of people will, you know, like we're going into a new house and you're talking about like, what do you think of this? And then I'll give my suggestion and then they'll be like, shut up, you stupid, tasteless fuck. You know, you'd be like, what colour floor you want? And I was, oh, maybe like a nice ashy wooden floor. And you're like, yeah, do you know who does that? Fucking stupid Nazi cunts. We're not doing that. And you'll just give me enough rope for me to hang myself with. What colour do you think these cupboards should be? I don't know, grey. Well, who has grey? Fucking, you know what I mean?
That's
fucking
not true
retards?
At all.
Retard grey, is that what they call it?
That's not
French
true.
French retard grey, when you look it up. Right down grey for retards. That's what you'll say.
That's not true. I respect your opinion because you've got good design ideas.
Wrong.
Then you'll say things that don't make any sense.
I think you only ask me so you can fucking shoot me down.
No, because say I did ask you about like, say, for example, floors, right?
If I'm
like, Colin, what kind of floors should we have? You turn around and be like, I don't know, but you know what's a really good idea? I would love, right, a sofa that twirls around. And you're like, that's not the question that I asked you. It was about a floor. And you go, yeah, but imagine a sofa that the sofa could be here. And I'm going to get a sofa. And you're like, that's not anything to do with what we're talking about. And you're like, yeah, but it'll be red. And you're like, but that's a totally different thing and has nothing to do with what we're talking about. Like, oh, what were you talking about? And that's what happens. And then you go, you don't care what I think. And you're like,
but what I'm saying is,
stupid floors.
You know, a lot of guys live in a house that looks like a woman's house because they just get no say on decor. So every house, if there's room, should have just an outhouse that's the man's house. Like, see, if there was a toilet and a bed in here, you wouldn't see me. I'd be dropping all my steamers out here.
Just on the floor like a dog. Like a dog kennel.
Somehow I feel like your mum would still, you know, she would come in and be like, sorry, I didn't want to go to the toilet inside, so I went out in that other one outside. And I'm like, I've just been doing chain dumps all day. Because that's the way men shit. Like, I'll say something like, oh, I'm going for shit. And you'll be like, are you shitting again? And I'm like, yeah, people's assholes work sometimes.
No, but how can you do it like twice or thrice in a day? It doesn't make, it's not.
Have you seen how much food I put away?
Yes, I do. Because it like costs a fortune. Again, like a big dog.
Cost you a fortune.
It's like owning a giant dog.
Cost you a fortune. Cost you a fortune. What a hot idiot you mean. That's what I'd be saying next time we have a ride. We're the Holiday Inn up. On you go.
See, I thought like putting a man in, like you're in the doghouse, was like a euphemism. It's not really. It's
no, they
actually
have to fucking do fake
like,
tears as
it's
they
because
walk away.
Having a husband is like having an actual large dog that just barks and eats and shits and stinks.
Leave.
You leave. This is my house.
I'd love to. I did a bad thing. I got married to my wife.
Shut up. I'm the best thing ever happened to you. And if you don't think so, the internet will tell you that.
Well, that's what we're, that's this whole, this whole podcast is going to be me getting berated about, like, you know, you don't deserve children. You don't deserve your wife. You don't deserve listeners. You fucking ugly cunt. And do you know what I'd love to know? I couldn't be the ugliest comedian around.
What?
But I feel like I get the most feedback about being an ugly cunt.
For some reason you do. Like, I think you get the most slagging.
And I also, you know, there's also a lot of comedians who, you know, are gross. And it's nonstop like, oh, look at all these pictures of tits. Oh, there's a girl fingering herself in her car. People just send me shit. And you're like, what's going on here? There's debt. But yeah, that's all I get. All I get is like, da da da, not bad for a big fat cunt, such and such. Oh, you should kill yourself because your wife's too hot for you. You should fucking leave your family, do them a favor. Don't ever do stand up again.
People don't say that.
They do. I'm bleeding. But yeah, we'll get into the questions. We'll soon
know. And those are just tweets for me.
I regret the thing I did. Yeah, that's I'll wake up.
That's just me in the house, isn't it?
I'll wake
to
up.
To you.
I'll wake up and I'll go, let me check if there was any questions. And then the first question will be like this. Sometimes in life you realize you're in over your head. You realize you could have had more. You realize that all of your talents went to waste. Wonder how you could be so dumb. Wonder why you deserve that twat you're with. And that's a question for your lovely wife. And I set up a Patreon going, do you know what? I'll maybe filter out some of the fucking assholes. And no, they get on in there. Now they're more fucking like, what's the word? Entitled.
Entitled to.
They're like, yeah, I pay $1 a month.
Which is, what is $1?
Fat except? Cunt.
What's a dollar? 80p? 70p?
Fucking
dislike it.
Oh, what is it? Fucking, it's like something at a fairground. I'll pay a dollar and fucking throw a bucket of shite at your face.
That is.
And then I miss a podcast for a week and they're like, Colin, you know what? Your podcast got us through a hard time. You're fat, ugly cunt.
That's what you're so ugly. It brings please, me joy. It brings me so much joy. I can't entertain
myself if you miss a week. You fat, fucking ugly cunt. How do you deal with mental health yourself? You fat, baldy, ugly cunt.
I hope your wife leaves you, but please tell me how you deal with my life.
Fair play to you for getting through this very tough year with a lot of stuff around you. Fat, baldy, ugly, useless fucking cunt. Everyone should look after their mental health and everything. Do you remember Caroline Flack? You fucking waste of space, cunt! What a holiday, ain't it?
Oh, yeah.
I regret the thing I did.
Which is what could become a comedian.
Huh? Oh, man.
I know. People. But you know what? I genuinely think anyone, especially on Patreon, I think they're only doing it to slag you in a fun way.
Yeah, but this is what happens when you're a comedian. I know a lot of funny people.
And people,
and you're not funnier than any of them.
Yeah.
Shut up.
Do you know what is the one thing I have noticed about people coming up to you? And people always ask me this. Like, what's it like? It's absolutely fine. But people have this idea about you, right? Where, especially guys, or girls as well, they come up and they either try and be really funny to you, but like in a not a funny way. Not even just like a normal funny way, but like really overly force it. Or it'd be so gross and like laddy and disgusting, and you're just sitting there sort of going, what? But I know a lot of these people aren't normally like this, but they put on this extra like something to talk to you. And I think they do that in the comments or like when you ask your questions as well. It's like, let's, you know, get us to love this, the most harshest fucking thing I can say to them. Or people will email you, like really nice professional people, and be like, all right, thanks very much, you fucking, you know. Yeah. Cunt. Like things they wouldn't say professionally.
People over here, like,
and you're like, why would you say that to Colin?
I've said this many times before.
I don't know if it's a familiarity thing, or do they actually, I don't know. It's funny. How people perceive you.
I've had people come up to me and they're like, oh, okay, maybe it wasn't the other photo and all. And you're like, okay, you get a photo with somebody, and then they go, I'll get one with you too, you fucking big, you're not wise, you fucking stupid cunt. And the guy is quivering. You fucking puss.
No, but if people just came up to you, I was like, hey, Colin, like, can I get a photo? And you're like, yeah, of course you can. And just talk like you talk to your regular friend. And most people do. There's lots of people who do. I'm not saying people don't do that, but it's just funny. Some, especially guys, I think, put on this extra, like, oh, we're just fuck, you know, I'll be trying to be extra gross or disgusting or funny.
Yeah, I've
and they're actually just being mean.
I've met people and like, aww, minutes later they're going like, oh, I know, looking left the wife and all, I've got this new 23-year-old girlfriend, no, fucking non-stop buckling, I fucking want to see a picture of her fucking uterus. And you're like, why are you showing me this?
No, because people don't know this, but you're the kind of person who doesn't like stuff when people show you that. You're like, oh, okay, I don't want to hear that.
Well, no, show me a picture, you know, of someone's uterus for sure.
You come back and you cry to me, Colin.
No, I don't like that sort of like, you gotta pull out all your best fucking dirty stories, yeah, so that I'm gonna laugh at you.
Yeah, just be nice, man.
Just fuck off. Don't come near me.
Just be, but like most people are funny. Just
lockdown vibes, yes.
What?
I can do that now.
What?
Don't come near me.
Don't come near me, yeah. Halt.
Halt.
I've always wanted to tell someone to halt.
I'm just providing a service. I do a podcast, I'll do some stand up. You come, you laugh, you fuck off. You know, it's like any other service. You don't need to like buy a newspaper, the news agents, and then be like, I saw the wife likes reading the papers and all from here. Guess what? La 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 la. I'm in the ghetto. What a holiday, innit?
Anyway, what was this question again?
How you feeling, Maureen? Feeling good? Everyone's always asking about you, yeah.
Yeah, I feel okay. We've got a big PET scan tomorrow, which is a bit scary, but...
PET scan, a.k.a. the all clear scan.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I mean, it's scary because I have to go to the Royal in the midst of a pandemic also, which is not ideal for me right now, but anyway.
The good thing
you
is...
You get to go to the part called nuclear medicine, which is quite exciting sounding, isn't it?
Nuclear or nuclear?
Nuclear.
Nuclear?
Clear. Clear.
All right, George Bush. Aluminum.
I don't know how to say it now that you've said that. Nuclear.
Yeah, it's like The Simpsons. They get the wee glow-in-the-dark green thing and push it in your butt and your whole body lights up.
I glow up like, what do you call him? Mr. Burns when he's like walking through the forest.
Ooh. I don't get that reference because I've never watched any
You've never watched Simpsons? It's so weird.
No, but I think you go to that hospital, that part of the hospital, you go in, you go up the stairs, you walk down the corridor and you go into that area. It's
and there's
not,
no one there,
you know,
really.
It's not like... You're going in the ward and sitting in a bed between people and a bunch of nurses are coming at you.
Well, it's not like an outpatient thing where you're like sitting in a waiting room with like, even though they're not really doing that much anyway, but do you know what I mean? It's not even a communal area. You just go in and it's like, you go into this little private thing. Anyway, it's weird.
And I'll go get a McDonald's or something for half an hour. I'm joking. It's not even open, is it?
Nothing's open, Colin. You have to just wait.
So yeah, that's a weird one, but it's fun. Yeah, we'll get that done and we'll come back. Hopefully there's just good weather for a wee while. It's not.
That would be nice.
We're dealing with lockdown okay, because you can just chill out. And
also, to be fair with the baby, like the days are just like flying by for me, because you're it's like 8 o'clock and you're going, oh my God, how is 8 o'clock?
Yeah.
I've done this, I've just, you always like with the baby, you're always like, right, okay, you know, once, okay, I'll feed him now. Okay, we'll feed him and then we'll play for a bit and then he'll probably say, then I'll get something done. And like, oh, no, he's awake now. And then, okay, now we're playing. And then it's like, right, well, I better eat something. And you're like, right, okay, now we've eaten. Okay, he needs fed again. And then you're like, it's 8 o'clock. You're like, I haven't actually done anything.
Yeah.
I haven't done one extra thing apart from like after a baby. So actually, to be fair, having a baby, everyone's complaining about like being stuck at home with their kids. But like, it definitely is more distracting than if you're just sitting at home bored, like.
I know,
so but it sounds
class
now,
though, doesn't it? Just sitting at home doing nothing.
No, I wouldn't like it. Honestly, I wouldn't like it.
I think what you want, like,
I love having a baby right now.
What you want is just to be able to have a little bit of variety in your day.
Yeah,
the baby's great, but sometimes you're just like, you know, when you're like, it's just some days you're like, oh, up, you know, just up again. My eyes don't work yet. Making a bottle. There's a bit of that where it's like, just a bit fucking. Repetitive.
Well,
nearly.
Yeah, because babies need routine and we don't have routine. Yeah, that's
but you
why.
Know, do you know when you miss? Like,
they are in a routine.
You know, like you could have a day where you're just at home with a baby, you're chilling out, and then you could have a day where I have to go to Belfast and grab something, or we can go out in the morning for a coffee. You know, you can just mix it up a wee bit. Where sometimes it's just a wee bit like
I know.
Yeah.
Whereas if
leave
wasn't
the
like,
baby outside for the wolves. No, I'm joking.
If it wasn't lockdown right now, at least we could be like. You could go to a few places. Because he's a really funny age where he's just like fun right now.
Just to
but,
mix it up a wee bit, you know.
But yeah, you're essentially stuck inside with your baby. Can't really do much. And he's also too young really to even
it's gonna be hilarious. Yet, so. It's going to be hilarious once he can sort of like move a wee bit. Because already you're just like, he's so boisterous, you know. And he's like he's learned to scream.
Just screams.
And to like other people would be like, is he okay? And you're like, oh, he's fine.
Oh, he's not upset.
He's having a wheel of it. He's just going, woo! Like screaming.
He's basically that guy at a festival who just runs around with no top on screaming for no reason. But you're going, they're having the time of their life.
I feel like he's going to be just a rowdy boy.
Yeah, he's just like, wah!
You know, like people come in and be like,
so happy though.
You're not putting clothes on. You're like, listen, he screams the house down when we put a nappy on him. So he's got
but
well.
But will there be those
kind
of
wellies
like,
and a hat
cares?
And pissing all over the place?
Oh, who cares? I mean,
yeah, who cares?
The child. It's wonderful. He hasn't seen anything in the world. Everything is new to him. Do you know how exciting that must be?
Yeah.
Everything is new. What he hasn't even tasted proper food yet. Do you know how exciting that's going to be?
Yeah. What's the first food you're going to give him?
Bolognese.
Broccoli. You're supposed to start with bitter vegetables.
So like yourself?
What?
I don't know.
You're supposed to start off with that.
So, yeah, because you see people...
not yogurts, not fruit, nothing sweet. Because they've only eaten sweet. Milk is sweet, obviously. So you're supposed to start them off with bitter vegetables.
Who was it? You don't have to give names. I was talking about working with a family that might have been travelers. And they were like giving the baby brown sauce and custard.
I don't know.
Read some books.
But you read anything on, baby
weaning. Imagine just being like, I tell you this baby, like the most acidic tart brown sauce.
Oh yeah, because he just thought it was liquid.
Because
it was
soft.
Mush. Yeah, it was soft, yeah.
go to school.
I know.
That's mental, isn't it? Yeah, because, or even yogurts and stuff, like,
don't even, I don't think I'd give him a yogurt, honestly, till he's like,
because there's not some bullshit, like, there's three? More sugar in a fucking patty flu, oh my God, than there is like
sugar, yeah,
than there is a load of other shit.
Yeah, I wouldn't give him one of those, like,
just give him a spoon and a fucking, the biggest,
give him yogurt, like, but not
the biggest tub of fudge yogurt you can get your hand on.
I don't know if they can eat Greek yogurt, but they could eat something
like, also that. Don't tell me that's pronounced fire.
It is
fudge, bro.
It's fudge, you know.
Get me the fudge, stick some fucking, there is a thing called fudge, isn't there? It's a very, like, Ulster fry type thing. Yeah. There you go.
Is it?
So it's basically what people would call, like, potato bread. Oh, man. Wouldn't you absolutely just milk for a bit of potato bread?
I made soda bread the other day, remember?
It was great.
See? Oh, compliment from Colin.
And then your sister made one, which she made in the pan, which she,
well, that's actual like, soda.
Came,
like,
came out like a fucking pizza.
Yeah.
Base, basically. It was... But it was like really tough.
Mine was more like a wheaten soda bread kind of thing.
Now let's talk about all the calories that I've counted this week. And
well,
I'll tell you
did start off, you like everything. You start off really well,
but
and then you just descend into I don't even care anymore.
Yeah, sometimes
so that's great.
Listen, food is the only joy I'm getting these days. But the here's what you do.
What I do?
No.
What?
I forget what I was gonna say.
Nutritional advice.
Oh yeah. Máirín made cookies and they were the best cookies I've ever tasted in my life.
Thank you.
And then you tried it again. Disgusting.
I know. I did. Well, they weren't disgusting, but didn't make, they were wrong.
Yeah, they were disgusting. But the first ones were unbelievable. Best ones I've ever tasted.
Yeah. And do you think that was your downfall?
No. I'd given up long before that. I think I keep seeing things as obstacles and it's a mental, it's a scapegoat. But I'll be like, you know, remember I was going,
isn't
like
it a scapegoat?
It's a scapegoat.
A scapegoat. My goat has escaped, guys.
I'm the escape. By the way, my 2020 stand-up tour is going to be called The Goat of All Time.
Yeah, and you keep, it obviously is because you've said this
the greatest
thrice now.
The greatest of all time of all time.
Because it makes, look at you, you can't even not giggle when you say it. Because you love it so much.
I do not regret the thing I did.
You love it, don't you?
I regret the thing I did. I want some fudge in my mouth. And take that as you fucking may, will.
Anyway, what were we talking about again?
So like, you know, I was deep into the no carbs. Remember?
Which is no, but stupid.
Let me talk. And then that all went off the rails because we were in hospital and everything. And then, you know, come around and there was like, I'm cutting calories. And then just, there was lockdown and I was like, well, what am I going to do? Be skinny for a fucking zombie? Nah, let's get fat.
Right, there's no zombies.
I know. But this is the sort of mental weakness I'm talking about. What do I have for lunch?
I don't know because you've ate all the food.
Yeah, I need to...
Every time we get food, you eat all of it.
Yeah, I'm such a good food guy though. Like yesterday we were all helping out with the house and I made hot chicken sandwiches for everybody.
Yeah, but you didn't have to make 35 sandwiches with like, well, how many?
Eight
25 chicken breasts. Like, you know, you can cut them up. Do you know what I mean?
They were cut up.
Most people don't need... like two chicken breasts per sandwich.
And what do we call them? Pussies.
No, but you could share them, you know what I mean? Ration. See, you would have died in the war, honestly. When you had a ration food, you well, would have been like,
all,
well, I'll just
first
kill
of
me.
All, what war?
Any of them.
The war? First of all, you wouldn't miss me with a bullet. I got into a snowball fight.
No, I mean, you'll die because you'll just like not know how to, you'll just be like, oh my God, what? I can't eat seven meals a day.
I got into a snowball fight when I was at university. We were coming back from the shop and it had snowed and someone threw a snowball and I started throwing snowballs back just for the crack. And not once did they miss. These two kids, I got riddled. Just I was getting hit from all fucking angles. And I was like, yeah, I'm too big. Wow. I regret the things I ate. Let's do some questions.
Oh dear.
What a holiday
year. I mean, I'm hungry now.
So am I, I'm starving. Outside of Belfast, Northern Ireland, where would you consider living? That's from Brian. Shout out to Brian. I'll tell you what mine are.
Santa Monica.
I'd live near the beach in LA.
Yeah.
I could live in Amsterdam.
I could live in Amsterdam.
See, like, I know people are like, oh, you fucking hookers. And all. See, like...
No, Amsterdam's beautiful.
Up a wee bit, like, when you get out of that sort of red light district, it's fucking gorgeous, like, and I it's just... It. You know, Mercedes estates everywhere.
But it's even like, just thinking
I'm
like,
I'm so European. Look how sensible I am. E63 up
but like really nice coffee shops, like they're little, like they've got such good like public transport. You just jump on and off their little like tram, all the museums and all the big like outdoor parks. Also,
it's big, not that hot, tall blonde dudes like you like.
Well, in Belgium, there's a lot of hot, tall blonde dudes in there. Do you remember?
What are you going to say about Belgium?
Just if you're talking about.
No one's talking about Belgium.
Okay.
Well, where were we in Belgium when there was hot dudes? Bruges or something?
Yeah, do you remember all the like. All the bars, it's all the
oh, yes, right, okay.
Barmen.
Yeah. Yeah, I get you. Yep.
Bridges nice. But, you know, anywhere, because it's so lovely over there, and the weather is so much nicer, even though it's not that far away from here.
Yeah, I could live there. They're the two places I could sort of live. But then also, lovely. Like, we visited your uncle.
Dutch people are lovely.
In England.
Yeah.
What is that, the South Downs?
Yeah, very, very South
Downs. Now, you say, oh, yeah, let's live there. I think we've about... £100 million more to make before we could buy
No, you would not be able to buy a house there, like,
and it's so English that
you can't even buy houses there,
but it's so old school English, and then they're like, we're so English that they're like, let's buy this pile of stones with a nice rickety door, and it's eight million pound, and you're like, but it's so English, they're all like, it's in the village, we can go here, you know, we can park fucking 9 Jags outside. And it's basically a pile of sideways stones with a brook running through the middle of the house. And they're like, it's 40 million.
Yeah. Your bed, your kitchen and your toilet is just one room.
And how English is it to just be like, I haven't had a haircut ever and I'm worth 200 million. But then also I'm just wearing this old hoodie that I've had since university or something. You know what I mean? They're kind of like, it's like so much money, but not flashy really.
But everything's cool.
Is that like a country thing? Is that because it's a wee probably, bit rural? Yeah.
But it's just gorgeous out the back where my uncle lives. Like, he literally has a palm tree. It's so hot. Like, it can get so hot there because it's so
southern. No, it's plastic.
Southern.
It's plastic.
It's not.
It is plastic.
It's not.
Oh, it is.
It's not.
I scraped the paint off it. No, it's gorgeous. It is very nice.
It's but, like, it's literally so gorgeous out their back. Like, there's photos. Every time you look at it, you're like, you look like you're on holidays at their house. It's beautiful.
Yeah, when they FaceTimed the other night and there was like a palm tree and like little fairy lights.
Oh my God.
And like nice grey decking and all. You're like, this is outrageous.
A hotel.
And we're over here stuffing old furniture in a chimenea. Choking everyone out, near killed the baby. Right, here's another question.
Okay, go.
Mark Schofield.
Schofield? It's not many. Schofield.
That's not the way you spell Schofield as in Philly Schofield, is it? Schofield?
Schofield? I don't know.
We had tickets to see you at the SSE, but weren't able to make it. Well, lose my number. Our friends went and got some sweet merch. I was wondering if the stuff was on sale at the show was going to be on sale. Yeah, it is. And people,
do you know what? Someone actually messaged me, and I've lost the message on Instagram. And they went, "When is the merch going to be on sale?" Because I think I was wearing the hat.
I'm in a bit of a predicament because, first of all, the merch is here. I need to just get it on the Spotify shop. But then it's a weird time. Because I'm not really supposed to be leaving the house that much. And it would have to be, it'd be like coordinating, posting loads of stuff every day. And I'm trying to limit that for a minute. So,
well,
you might have to wait.
The timing was supposed to be, obviously, new office. We had did a really big order of merch.
Yeah.
Alongside all the shows so that it was supposed to coincide together. And then we have the office so we can actually properly sort out stuff and get it sent really well and quickly.
Yeah.
And now we can't be in the office in Belfast. We can't leave the house.
Yeah.
It's hard to post things, etc. So you've actually stopped the shop for a minute.
Yeah, I've just, there's nothing for sale at the minute. But
we had thought actually because of the show, that merch was actually supposed to be limited just to the shows, weren't they? Because it was like, if you come to the show, you get all the really cool merch right now. However, we might, just because of lockdown, put some of it on sale, maybe, for people who didn't, who missed it.
I have to sell all of it. Yeah. I'm not going to hold on to it. Like, but there's like loads of water
bottles.
Because
we're not doing shows. There's no shows
loads
now.
Loads of beanies and stuff.
The beanie is probably,
I need to
the
look into
it.
If I can get it, if I can do a certain thing where like...
Did we get more grey hoodies that everyone loves? No.
No.
See, they are the best.
I can get them though. But
we could do a reorder.
It's kind of like, if I could figure out a way where like I printed out the postage, slapped it on, put it in a bag and had a these things do exist, like a prepaid card. You just go in, leave the card with them and just leave all the shit and be like, bye, which I would like to do. But again, it's that's all work, and it's fucking hard to kind of do at the minute.
Because we obviously can't get anyone to help us now, you know?
Stephen Donald. What about the fact
will be.
That it's £500 fine if you don't pick up dog shite, but 30 if you leave the house and spread a killer virus? Is it only £30? I thought it was like 780. Well, let me tell you something. Put some dog shit in your mouth and tell me how long you last. I don't know what that means.
Are people right now, are they being fined if they're leaving?
I don't know where.
I suppose
though.
Like...
Because you have to leave your
house. No, but I don't think it's that. I think it's like if you're just like unnecessarily spending lots of time wandering around the place, maybe in like a city, say, or a built-up area. Yeah. Obviously, you shouldn't do that.
We have like 20 questions here, so we'll pick up the pace a wee bit.
Okay.
Mick Conlon, shout out to Violin Mick. Ultimate brunch in Belfast. I'm a sucker for established French toast and a wee Rwandan filter. Where do you miss? We've talked about it before.
General Merchants is good.
General Merchants in Belfast, yeah.
Sounds so like basic, but like their bread is so nice, like their toasted bread.
Yeah, that makes a difference. That makes a difference.
It does though, it really does. Just the small things like that.
Coffee's good.
Coffee's good.
But they just it's just like I say this all the time. I want to eat a thing where that I couldn't knock it up at home.
Yeah.
So like you get that fucking eggs with the chili and all through it. Mm. You're not necessarily gonna do that at home.
Yeah, because there's lots of bits to that.
There's black beans in it, there's bacon, there's black pudding, you know. Yeah. That's a lot of shit to go in. Okay, Steve McCann, there's an app called Sleep Talk that records you when you talk in your sleep, which can be funny in itself. People load up their recordings, and it's fucking hilarious. It's mostly blokes farting and their partners being disgusted. At least the recordings from UK and Ireland. There's a recording called There's a Womble in the Bed, and that's very funny. Check it out. I certainly... Oh, that's... Is that it there? Hold on a second. Am I able to quickly get this?
I don't think either of us talk in our sleep, do we?
No, because I would have thought that I would be a very loud, like snore type guy. But apparently I'm not.
No, only when you're drunk.
But that's everybody. Like,
I know.
Because your body thinks it's dead. But like, no, I don't think, I just think I just lie there.
I mean, Dutch Frank talks real... a lot, and it's like my sister records him all the time and just will be like, look what he said last night, but like full sentences, like,
and he's all like,
ask questions.
I hate the blacks. Who's more racist than Dutch people?
Yeah, Dutch people don't like
him. He's pathologically racist. Not him, just all Dutch people.
And he always finds it hilarious that he's moved over here and everyone's like, you know, 12th of July, King Billy, and like who was
and
Dutch.
You know what he said?
And
he
Frank
said,
was like, no one even knows who,
like,
that is.
King Billy was a wee Protestant faggot. That's what he said.
No, but Frank would be like, why do this? Why do they
like,
do this?
This was, wee gay.
No one cares about that in Holland. Like,
well, he wasn't. He was Welsh, or was that St. Patrick? I'm getting them all mixed up. He was Welsh.
But do you know what I mean?
King
That's
Billy
funny.
Was scared of snakes, unless it was pant snakes.
Yeah, just mix them all up.
Is that noise you just made?
That was you. That was you. Record it.
Is there an app that records burps? I regret the things like Jack White.
Woo!
Yep. Do you ever see R. Kelly Hip Hopera Trapped in the Closet? Particularly chapters 10.
I actually never did see that.
No, it's a fucking, it's a bit.
I never did watch it.
It's a bit much to get into now, but is there chapter 9? We'll play this. It's 2 minutes long. Now, this is some old school shit. After this, we're going to play Charlie Bit My Finger.
He looks around the kitchen and says something is really weird. Then she says, why do you say that? He says, because you keep trying to get me out.
What about him putting the accent on?
I know.
Why did you say that? I'm a fat white bitch.
He said, ever since I've been in this house, your face has went from white to red. And remember when I first walked through the door, you act like you had seen a ghost from the dead. Then he says, girl, if you hide.
This is on a par with Russell Crowe and fucking like this. I'm just saying things. Russell Crowe.
You should mix that in with the girl on the bike.
Something I'm gonna be so
la 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 la. Hey, we got him.
it. They put a Holiday Inn at.
Something falling. He says, what the fuck was that? She said, it sounds like it came from upstairs. Sounds like the plumbing. He said, woman, that sound did not come from upstairs. I'll be damned if you're not up to something. Said, now the sound that I just heard.
If your relationship gets to that point, should have been over a long time ago.
Yeah. What, you're hip-hopping each other?
Where you're like paranoid that there's noises in the house, and like, do you have another man in this house in a closet?
And then he walks over to the refrigerator and pushes it back. And then he looks her in her face, looks like she's about to have a heart attack. Then he notices the pie on the counter, one slice is missing. Now the story's getting scary, cause he comes to realize that Bridget is allergic to cherries. He looks up at her.
Now there's a title of a book. Bridget is allergic to cherries. Oh my god, I'm dying.
How insane is R. Kelly?
He's a pedophile, that's how insane he is.
That doesn't mean, like, he's just so weird.
And then he looks at the cabinet. He walks to the cabinet. Get close to the cabinet. Now he's opening the cabinet. Now pause the movie, cause what I'm about to say to y'all is so damn twisted. Not only is there a man in his cabinet, but the man is a midget. Midget, midget, midget.
What?
Fucking hell, bro, don't leave me on. That's like, this is worse than fucking Breaking Bad. Leave me on the edge.
Now the midget jumps out of the cabinet and stumps the policeman on his toe. The policeman's hopping around on one leg, screaming, son of a bitch, why he runs under the table?
We can't go we can't listen to all that.
What? I'm so confused.
No, you're not.
Now
there's a midget in a cabinet. What's in the cabinet?
The cabinet?
What's in that fucking cabinet? There's a fucking midget in the cabinet?
Yeah, no one goes in cabinets, do they?
So yeah, that's just a work of art, really. I mean, you know,
I mean, what? Sometimes how do you describe that?
People are like, can you appreciate the artistry when someone's done something? Can you listen to Michael Jackson, even though he's effed some K's?
you can say kids, like.
Oh, you know, this guy, you know, had banged a lot of fucking young teens.
Yeah.
Pissed on them.
Mm.
But, you know, you gotta fucking crack some eggs to make an omelet. And you come out with this fucking genius. What's in the cabinet?
What's in the cabinet?
You can't even say midget anymore. Imagine that's the issue you took up with the R. Kelly. Bro, you cannot say midget anymore.
Man, like, you can't say that.
He's pissing on fucking second years.
What's in the closet?
A toilet. Piss in there.
Yeah, what? Get a doghouse and piss outside, we call him.
Yeah, and then have Maureen's family walk in shortly after him. Like, what's this beefy whiff? Mark Casey, favourite bits from celebrity roasts. There's too many to mention, but the very, very best one is Patrice O'Neill from, what you call it? What do you call him? Tiger Blood? What's his name? Charlie Sheen?
Charlie Sheen. I don't know what you were trying to say there.
Man, I'm fucking losing my mind. Patrice O'Neill, I wonder is this clip.
You forget the Tiger Blood thing, don't you? Because of Tiger King now, so you think of tigers.
See, this isn't even, like, available, really. It's a hard one to get your hands on.
Our next roaster is Patrice O'Neill.
This is audio just?
You may recognize Patrice from his many speaking roles in movies, but only...
Shut up. But the cool story behind this was, like, he had a lot of stuff written and he had to write it on very short notice. And then ended up just winging it.
It's strange, because...
And it's exactly the type of comedy I like where... Everyone can fucking do all their silly buggers, and then he just has like fucking sniper shot.
You always said that about him, don't you? Like, he sort of just.
But I didn't.
Anyone could say something, but he will just come and go, oh, well, that's how you say it. That's how you make that
like,
bit funny.
It's a bit like Chappelle now, where it's like, oh, everyone has a trans bit. Everyone has a fucking whatever. And then he'll do a bit, and you go, okay, well, fuck.
That's it done now. Yeah.
What am I doing?
Like, I didn't know William Shatner was going to be quasi, like, an old racist man. Like, but. But everybody's giggling, like, whoa, he's a butt. You're a fucking asshole, Captain Kirk.
What are you talking about?
Like, I don't respect him, but like, I'll respect him, because he's fucking Captain Kirk. But I think he might be racist because his hair plugs look like black girls' pussy hair.
my God.
This is fucking amazing. Like, I wasn't gonna be mean to Anthony. I don't know him, I never met him. Like, so I'm sitting here watching him and I'm like, he has way too much confidence. Like, in my world, he's an open micer. Nobody knows him. And nobody should. Like, nobody should fucking know Anthony. I refuse to learn his last shitty name.
Jeselnik.
I learned Gallifrey.
Anthony Jeselnik, like, and he's like, I refuse to learn this concept. You're an open micer to me. Like,
that's the last shitty last name. Hear that? Nobody knows him. And nobody should. Like, nobody should fucking know Anthony. I refuse to learn his last shitty name.
I love it. I refuse to learn his name.
That's the last shitty last name this nigga's gonna learn in this fucking funky town. He reminds me of a medieval restaurant waiter. Like, his old demeanor, like, hello, may I welcome to, and you just wanna go, shut the fuck up and bring me my giant turkey leg, you fucking nothing.
It's just fucking ruthless.
How the fuck can I be too mean after all this shit? I can't believe it. I'm dying of diabetes and you motherfuckers are like, oh, that evil fat puff, you know.
There is something about, I get that a bit too. We're like, I could go on after Mickey and everyone's doing all this dirtiest shit and Mickey's coming on his own neck and fucking people in the ass, and then I say something and everyone's like, oh, Colin, distasteful. Maybe Trace O'Neill are the same, by the way.
I consider Seth
dying of diabetes.
Like, I got a critique about Seth. It's too much Seth. It's like, it's almost like he's jealous of his own creation.
Hold on a sec. Where's the Charlie Sheen?
Once to say, hey man, don't forget why people love you. And two, just say you're gay. No.
Where's the Charlie Sheen?
Ride that whole Steve-O shit till the wheels come off, man. Girl, you're like, boy, I had more for that nigga than I didn't say it. I should have said it, because he's a... But when I say legend, I mean a myth. Like the Loch Ness Monster or Bigfoot, like... We all believe they exist, but who really ever saw it? Oh, shit. I've turned down many roasts. I have. About 3 or 4 of them. And I said yes to this, and I'm dead ass serious. I said yes to this because I respect Charlie Sheen. I do. I said yes because I respect not
this joke's buying him.
Not his body of work. Like, not. It's all been very Christian Slayer-ish. Like, it just like. He sucks, but he's good. But he sucks at the same time. I think that his stand that he made against the business, I think this is a fucked up business, but he stood up, he still survived, and he proved that nobody can keep like a Sheen down, you know? They can keep a Esteves down, because his brother, and he's the good one. That motherfucker do everything right, and that nigga's career is over. Holy shit!
We do this line. This is great.
Fuck Tiger Blood, he's selling his own blood to make money. But I want to say to your eyes, man, I love that you...
Anyway, you gotta listen to that whole thing. It's like, no, I shouldn't play it. There's ink in my mouth, I can taste it. But yeah, that's the best one. Right, let's rip through these. Would you rather Aaron... Oh, fuck. Would you and Aaron ever consider doing some music? No. We played some mumble rap and said we could rap better than it. Yeah, I mean, we'd do something like that for the crack maybe, but like, it's a lot of fucking work and I'd have to do it all. Which one of you will be good cop and bad cop once Eddie hits troublemaking years?
Oh God, I don't know.
Oh, you'll be bad cop, I'll be good cop, sure.
I'm the voice of reason where you're like...
Will you stop wrecking the place if I take you for ice cream?
Yeah.
That's right. I'll be like, am I rewarding bad behavior?
I feel like he might be shouting at you for being annoying.
So.
We'll just have to deal with that when we come to it, probably.
Yeah, we joke around. I'm a good parent. I'm a good guy. Not fine. Cheers for sending me links that don't work, you fucks. Uh, No questions. How did you get Lavery's Comedy Club to what it is today? How did it all start?
That's a good question. How long has Lavery's been going?
I don't know. I would have to work it out. Like, it's probably
it's
like...
It's been nearly 10 years at least.
Let me just check the time. 20 minutes. It's probably like 8 years, 7, 8 years. I would say, would it be? On, off?
More?
More, you think?
From when it really started? Because I remember we were doing Lavery's when I was in uni in Glasgow, because you would get the boat home to do it.
Yeah.
And that was in 2012, and it had already been going for a little while before.
It was kind of on and off.
It was on and off.
It was definitely like once a month.
It was like a little sort of random gig that was held, and then it started to be like, right, let's do this every month.
Yeah.
Strange. And you sort of like just went, we both sort of went, let's make sure we keep it going every month. Yeah, you really have to like stick with something like this. You don't start a comedy club because you think like, this sounds fun or this sounds easy or...
Or I'm going to get loads of money.
I'm going to get loads of money. You're not. It takes a really long time. It really does, because I've seen a lot of nights clubs start and stop.
Yeah.
As quick as it started, because you think it's like, this is super easy. You have to put a lot of like effort into it.
You have to keep going for ages, and then you really have to actually... You can't give up with it. You have to care about it a lot.
You have to care about it. You have to have like an idea of like what you want it to be like, because we always just, or like I certainly had like, I know how I want this to be. Like I know how I would like this comedy club to be and why we're doing it. Yeah. We have a reason why we're doing it, and that's what keeps us going. It's not just for like one individual night. That's good. It was like, let's keep this going. Let's bring... Our idea was always like, there's not enough live comedy in Northern Ireland, especially Belfast. That being a city, you know, a big city, there should be more live comedy, and there wasn't. So we're like, let's make a really good night. Yeah. And also let's sort of kind of teach people how to watch live comedy, because people go to maybe one big show a year, maybe in like SSE or something, and they see one comedian, and then they might come to like, you know, a local, more of a local show in Belfast, say, with like comedians that aren't on TV, for example.
Yeah.
You know, as if that's a bad thing. And they don't really know how to watch comedy. Whereas you go to somewhere like Glasgow, people know how to go to a comedy club because there's comedy clubs and there's The Stand and it's on every night. People in Belfast don't know that.
Another thing
So we always thought like we need to like show people how you're supposed to come to a comedy club. And, you know, I will go and tell you to be quiet. But, I will kick you out if you're disrupting people.
But another thing that I wanted to do was like let everyone... sort of, you know, like get everyone sort of up to a certain level, and then be like, you know, because it used to be like you'd have to fucking beg to do other gigs and can we get in, whatever. And I wanted, and I knew all the comedians up here were way better, and I wanted it to be like, this is where the fucking good comedians go to like fuck about. And I want it to be like clicky, because only good comedians get in. Like all the guys like Chris Kent and every, like, his specials on RTE, you should watch it. But like people like him or Tom or whatever, people who are, we know are good and they come up regularly. I want it to be a wee bit like, you have to be fucking class. Because I know some of the comedians.
We have a level of some like of the skill comedians, we like to keep it.
Some of the
like.
Comedians in Belfast I know are like better than anybody across the UK.
Yeah.
There's a lot of places I've been, including like the Comedy Store in LA, where I'm sitting here going, these people are okay. If they're like paid regulars in here, it's all right. Like, it's a bit fucking pedestrian. Whereas like with, you could put the right lineup on in Lavery's and like everyone fucking murders. Like not like I'm going up to, like people don't, you'd see people at the Comedy Store in LA like, I'm just, oh, that bit didn't work, I'm just trying a new wee bit or whatever. Whereas like, you know, you go up and you see Mickey or something, and like a bit that he just wrote it behind the fucking curtain. Yeah. And people are falling off their seats. Like, the level is ridiculous. And you have to be, like, bringing major heat to fit in the lineup. And all these cunts are like, oh, can I get another gig in there? And you're like, well, you fucking had dick about three times in a row. Clearly you're not ready. Like, you're not ready to fucking be put on in the middle of all these animals.
Yeah, like, I know. There's a reason that, like,
Woodsy can be like, I'm quitting comedy. And then he comes up one day and just fucking
eviscerates
the place. And you're like, oh, maybe you should fucking quit every week. Everybody's lethal.
Yeah.
You know?
But also, like, we kind of knew that. Like, we wanted somewhere, like, in Belfast, which is close enough to majority of good comedians, especially at that time coming up, we sort of saw the fact that so many of these comedians, now I'm talking about now, like it seems obvious now, but imagine this is like 6 years ago, say, when maybe these people weren't doing big shows, doing tours, all those things didn't really exist then, podcasts, etc. Like you were doing a podcast then, but no one else was really. But we kind of had this idea that like we wanted to showcase people and give them somewhere that like they could do just comedy so much in a good environment that they would get really good. So we would keep bringing on similar people a lot of the time for a reason, because we really wanted them to do better. We wanted them to be like, we wanted to say to someone like Aaron, who, you know, a number of years, not that long ago, had never done comedy before. We knew he was so good. So we went, well, let's have him on all the time, because the better Aaron is, the better of a comedian he is for us to get back into our club.
Yeah,
people are excited to see Aaron because he's so good. Or, you know, now if he's on your podcast, people go, oh, that's that guy. Or maybe they've seen him on the podcast and they'll come to Larry's because they'll see him. So we kind of want, we always knew this. I mean, we've had this idea for years and years. We want, if we have a club that's really good and we keep people coming back, and we kind of get a really good audience coming who like comedy and want somewhere to go to watch good live comedy, it will make the audiences enjoy themselves more. It'll make the comedians who we know are really good better, because they have somewhere they can come all the time easily to practice comedy and do it and really get really comfortable in front of crowds and really like enjoy it. And we wanted that kind of like
people sort of copied like
family feeling where you go, oh, we're all here to have a good time. The comedians want to have a good, I want the comedians to have as good a time as the audience, and I want the audience to have as good a time. You know, I want everyone to be like,
but also
I really enjoyed myself. Laveries
needed to be a place where like actual good comedians who were local could try out, whereas people were, every club that opened in Belfast, they were copying the Empire sort of thing, which is, you know, you got an opener that no one gives a fuck about. You got an MC who's usually the best and most famous person there. And then a headliner that's from England.
And maybe no one,
and no one gives a shit, but everyone thought of it as this is the big
that's
show.
That's the way. Yeah.
This is the big show way to do it, which is like an opener, get you warmed up, big guy comes in and you do the circuit and you're there once a year. Whereas like all the comedy clubs in America, it's like, you know, you can see fucking 8 famous comedians messing about and trying stuff. That's the way, that's what an actual comedy club is. You want the show, you go see them on tour and a fucking,
we want it to be like a club, as in like it's a comedy club, as in like you're coming here to see this group of comedians who we have like selected over the years. It'll change, but like there's always some of the same people you will see on and off at most shows for a reason, because we want it to be like you can come and see them quite often just having fun.
Yeah.
And talking to you and like having a bit of crack, and you're coming, you know, we do it twice a month now, or we used to anyway, you know, you get to go, oh, it'll just be a bit of crack to see them again, and like what are they gonna say and like what's happening, and you know, you'll get regular people come to the club and you'll notice them and be like, oh, they're here all the time, and I'd be like, hey, they're, you know, oh, you're on a date tonight, oh, what's happening, and there's just this lovely feel about it that we like, that's the kind of vibe we wanted to like create, I suppose. We're like let's make it like somewhere really nice for people to come.
I miss turning up there more than I miss doing stand-up.
I miss it so much, like, because I haven't been able to go in months either, even when it was still going on, and I just like, I miss it so much, just the fun, or like just everything. Like we'll think about lots of different things, like lighting, all sorts of things that like I'm obsessed with that side of it, like just making it like how I just want it to feel really good. If you are
let slide and then you go into another place and they're letting the crowd in, and you're like, can you put some fucking music on here?
Or like, turn the lights off? Maybe the seating isn't right, or there's whatever. There could be so many subtle things can make or break a comedy club, really. But, and again, we've done it. There's plenty of years we were doing it where we would have to go out and go to the bank, pay people with our own money. Yeah. You know, like, it's not like something that's like, oh yeah, it's like the easiest. It's not. It's probably the hardest way to make money. It's not an easy way to do it.
There's definitely a lot of weeks where you're like, this is years ago, like, where you're like, oh shit,
this is costing
hopefully Laveries does well this week.
Please say it does okay.
And then there's just no crowd whenever the doors open, and then some people drip in, and then
it's so nerve wracking.
You have to go and like lift most of the fuck all money you have to pay someone, because you agreed to pay them like some ridiculous price.
And you're like, why did we say we could pay them that? Yeah, but that's what I mean. And then you get just, this is, again, I mean, I know this affects everyone, but again, why it's so sad all this happening now, because I feel like we had Laveries at like a good place where we had really good crowds every time.
Mm-hmm.
And it was kind of one of those things you're going, oh my God, I feel like we've actually done a good job here. It's been like nearly 10 years and we kind of I've just got to the stage where we know what we're doing. We've got like our own sound man. We've got someone who does the, I mean, I used to do all of that. I was on the door. I was the person like sorting the money to pay all the comedians.
We used like, to be like, thanks very much. Good night. And walk over to the mixer and
like,
music
turn out. It off on the stage. Like there's a guy to sound now, you know, there's bouncers there now and all, but you know, you know, we really enjoy it. And like, actually, you know, Jane, who does the door, and Michal, like he does the sound, like you miss seeing them. We all have good crack too. Like it's really lovely place to like, which you brings, know, which, to be together and have fun and make something really fun with. So
which brings
it.
Me to my next question. Do you think, it's from Michael Lavery, do you think when there'll be a baby boom once this is all over, people like bucking?
There could be. Everyone keeps saying this, didn't they?
Yeah.
Well, they said either it's that or there'd be like really high divorce rates because people are stuck with their like other halves and they might go, oh my God, because you forget. Like,
that rings a bell more with me.
No, but we've always spent all of our time together forever since the day we met.
What were telling me about it?
We both never had, I've kind of had jobs that you have to go and work, you know, in shifts and stuff like that. But pretty much forever, our whole relationship, we've never been apart. No. We're always together all day. We're used to it. Other couples maybe see each other like when they get home from work at like 6:30 until they go to bed, maybe sometimes 4 hours later.
Sometimes
five,
you hear about couples getting married and you're going, not really?
Yeah, do you actually know each other? Because you've never really lived together until you've lived together.
Yeah. Right, I'm very wary that this camera's going to run out of time in 10 minutes, so I'll quick fire you some shit, right?
Go for it.
Alexandra. Do any of you bake ever? Do any of you ever bake?
I bake.
You bake a bit, yeah.
I'm not someone who cooks a lot because Colin is a better cook.
Well, here's more quick fire questions.
But I love
baking. If Eddie could speak now, would his answer be mum or dad? Ready?
Okay.
Who's better in the kitchen?
Dad. Sure.
Who spends the most money?
Dad.
Who owns the most shoes?
Dad.
Who's the better gift giver?
It's a hard one.
No, it's not. As in, I give you lots of gifts and you give me none. Except the gift of life. No, I'm a fucking strange gift giver. I'm like,
you are, because you don't really. I've talked about this all the time.
I'll give you like a big gift 7 days out from Christmas.
That's what I was gonna say. Like I've talked about this all the time. You can't do surprises. You can't buy a gift for someone's birthday and not just give it to them the day you buy it. I can buy you something and save it, and then on your birthday, like what I get you for birthday, the guitar you could make yourself. You could build up your own guitar and something else in like a box. Put your watches in. So I'll think of like really like. I'm one of those people, I like to buy a gift that I actually think someone might like. Mm-hmm. I'm not a like gift set person, don't like that. See, generic, like here's the thing. Nah. Any of those kind of things, I would rather not buy someone it and go wait till I think of something really good I can get you than just buy it for the sake of
Whereas
it.
Whereas like I'll go.
To look like I'm giving you a present. I don't like that.
I'll go like shoe shopping.
I don't like those presents.
And then I'll see shoes that I think you'd like and I just buy them and go, this is a nice thing you should have. You should have fresh kicks.
We actually rarely get each other like Christmas Day presents or birthday on the day presents. Because usually we just buy them when we think of them. But I did get you something on your birthday last year. So there you go. But like you didn't like, you'll like get me really good gifts and then it'll be something else like Mother's Day and you went, oh, I didn't know you're supposed to get something. So you'll be like, so people might think that's unthoughtful, but that wouldn't bother me because you actually get me really nice things just randomly. If you think I might like it.
Yeah, I don't like the idea of someone will be like, oh, it's Mother's Day, so I made my ma fucking an egg on toast just today or something. You know what I mean? It's like, oh, you waited all year of being fucking slaved after and then you're like, I got this one. Here's a breakfast. You know what I mean?
Like it's cute if kids do that, but not if like a grown adult.
An adult are doing it.
Doesn't care.
Right, well, 8 minutes.
I don't know. Who knows?
As a child of expats in Canada, I've noticed that you and various guests have the same disdain for powerful emotions that I have. Grown men crying over football teams winning a game. Gross. Why do you think Irish men,
I love it, gross,
in particular, have such a hard time expressing any emotions? Extreme happiness or extreme sadness can be summed up as, yeah, I'm grand. It was fine. I've noticed my Canadian friends have much healthier relationships with emotions, whereas we always try to maintain our hard bastard mentality. You think it might be some kind of epigenetic trauma?
Ooh, la la.
Yeah, well, it for sure it is. I've heard numerous people talk about that.
Yeah.
You know, I heard the guy from Fontaine's DC saying, like, when Irish people, like, you know, oh, that's savage, or that's lethal, or that's whatever, they sort of make good things sound really nasty. And then they make, like, they'll say, like, I'm grand. Like, I'm literally grand, when you're like, oh, you're just not dead.
Yeah.
You know, they have a weird way of talking like that, which he was saying came from that sort of early, you know, British oppression type shit.
For sure.
Keep your spirits up. How are you? I'm grand. I'm, even though I'm chained to this fucking cart here.
Yeah, be kicked out of my house. But
sorry if that's a bit too much of a blind boy type question. Feel free to wrap it in a dick joke. On the subject of shit live Instagrams and Facebooks, last week I watched a Facebook live stream of a funeral service. Was the most shit live stream, but we did get to roast him. We did get to, or you knew the person, get to roast a minister in the comfort of her own home, and that didn't, wow. Hilarious.
But it is true about, like, suppressing things. People do just go,
what? So sure, yeesh.
Yeah. But, like, it is so true, isn't it? People over here just go, nah, you don't talk about that, you're fine.
Yeah, well, I mean, there is, like, I mean, people always talk about men's health. There definitely is. Like, say if you were like, oh, I'm feeling really bad today, I'd be like, what can I do? Can you want me to make you lunch today? If you're a man and you're like, I really don't feel mentally fucking, you know, strong today, it's kind of a case of, well, you should really fucking sort that out on your own before you bring your shit over to me. that's vibes I've got. I'm not like, that's just vibes I've got from being a man. So there is definitely, like, that sort of thing going on with Irish men.
Yeah, because I think...
But now I see why people are so forced. That, man, you got to talk to each other.
But I think it's too vague to say, do you know what, guys? Men, you know, get depressed too. Men should talk, and it's fine to talk. That's too vague to say that. I don't like when people say that. Is that wrong? Does that sound okay for me to say that? Like, I don't like when people go, do you know what? Guys, it's okay to talk about your feelings. You should just do that. Because a man's just going to turn around and be like,
yes,
that's all well and good, but I'm not actually going to do that, am I?
No.
What it should be is...
It needs to be very specific.
Let's be more... Let's give a man actual phrases he could bring up that make it easier to start the conversation about how I feel.
Let me say this.
Do you know what I mean?
I have actually... People need like a fucking... You know, like an instruction manual of like... Because I've done it before where, like, I was massively anxious and it was really... I still don't know how to get rid of it. That's the thing. It is vague. It's like...
It's too vague.
Go speak to someone. Let me tell you something.
Speak to someone.
Try fucking Googling, I have anxiety, who do I speak to? Where the fuck do you start?
I know, that's so vague.
There's no entry point. Like, even trying to get in contact with this guy, it was on a list of, you know, therapists that were attached to someone else. Then I emailed him and he was like, what sort of stuff is wrong with you? And you're like... This is too far down the line.
Yeah.
Other people would already be fucking at the end of a rope at this point. Do you know what I mean? It's like, there should be like a fucking, like a spec savers for mental health. Where you walk in and go, listen, I'm fucking, just, I don't know what the fuck's
like
going on.
Like
a
generic,
here.
Like, can it's, I come in
it's,
and just,
it's all,
just,
everything's
you tell
all
me.
Hidden. And I know a doctor can sort of send you to someone, but even that takes too long. But it's everything's all hidden and private and blah, blah. And by the way, what way are you going to pay for this? It's
also,
£70
do you know what it
session.
Is as well? Like, I'll ask you things. So say, like, I could maybe, like, articulate how I'm feeling quite well. Whereas if you were having a bad day or you felt really anxious and I would ask you, but how are you actually feeling? And I don't know, maybe this is me being very generalized, but say, for example, as a general man, you find it quite hard to describe how you're feeling. So you'll go, I don't know. Or I'll say, is it something like this? Or what kind of thing is maybe bothering you? And you go, well, I don't know. You need someone to tell you or give you examples of how you might be feeling so that you can go, yeah, that sounds like how
Point
it is.
Show me on the doll where he touched you.
No, but
you
know what I mean? But a lot of people who aren't used to talking about their feelings need someone to go, okay, I'm going to give you these sentences. Tell me which one sounds most like or what one can you sort of recognize most
that's what
as
they,
sounding like
that's what they
how
do,
you
do.
Might feel.
That's what they do at like a therapy
exactly.
thing for anxiety and depression.
But exactly, but that's only if someone gets, as you say, gets to there. But what, you know, that general term of like, oh, you should just speak to your friends about this. How can a guy or anyone, like a girl as well, it's not easy to go, by the way, I'm speaking to you about my feelings now and I don't know how they feel. So what, you know, you need to go, here's how you should come up to someone and say, you know, it should be things like, or sometimes I'll say to you, like, why don't you just say this to me? And then I'll know that this is when you're feeling bad.
You never do that.
Well, we've talked about this before where I'll say like, okay, Colin, instead of just being angry, why don't you say something to me like, you know, instead of shouting and kicking things, why don't you say something like, I'm just having a funny day today and I'm not sure how I feel. And I'll say, that's no problem. You go outside for a minute.
Wouldn't say that.
Okay, I'm giving an example.
You'd be like, you would literally be like, you can't bring that energy around me and the child. Go sort that out yourself.
I've never said that.
In more or less words.
Right, see,
join us next week where I'll be back by myself and no one will want to fucking listen. And there's 20 other Northern Irish podcasts to listen to. And people will forget that I ever had one for fucking 8 years before anyone else did. And they'll be like, oh, you just to do that other stupid podcast with a fucking guy. Fat.
Don't talk about your feelings, Colin. Okay. Are you feeling okay?
No, I don't enjoy anything except Kit Kats.
See, here's the thing. Ironically, you see this whole like, oh, Irish people are always like, oh, I'm grand, I'm fine. I wish Colin was like that. He's not. You never say you're fine. You're always like, I'm fucking, this is sore. I'm fucking fed up with this. So to be fair, Colin's really good at complaining and he's not one of those like generic Irish people who's like, do you know what? Everything's fine and I'll be grand and I'll get on with it.
I read this quote and it was
Colin is like, not that guy.
Most men live lives of quiet desperation, which is like a reminder to be like, do whatever you want and really get the most out of your life. Problem is, in real life, you do what you want to do, people will be like, he's a cunt. Join us next week
for more inspirational quotes from Colin.
And the main question is, and it's a question that's been haunting humanity for a long time, what a holiday, isn't it?
Do I look too like the Edge with hats on now? That's another question.
Yeah.
I don't like it. I don't like wearing beanies. I'm getting a wig soon, guys, so don't worry about it.
Shout out to Material Goods for the
hat. I don't know, Material Goods hat. It's nice. It's a nice wee one. It fits my head nice.
Right, listen, we have 30 seconds left. Thanks for being my guest today, Maureen.
There seems like there's other good questions. Do you guys plan on having more kids?
Oh, well, fuck me. You have 24 seconds. Yes.
Yeah, I'd love to.
But that involves intercourse, and Maureen is not attracted to me. We'll see you next week. Where the Holiday Inn at? My new apartment, aka is what it's called now. We're moving out to. 10 seconds, 9, 8, 7. We gotta go. See you next week, guys. Say bye, Maureen.